Well, the next subtopic is 3.2, okay? Conservation of linear momentum. Okay, the first one, student should able to state the principle of conservation of linear momentum. The second one, student should be able apply the principle of conservation of linear momentum in elastic and inelastic collision in one dimension. 3.2.1, principle of conservation of linear momentum. Okay, state the total linear momentum of system of body is constant. Okay, if no external force act on the system. And we can write summation F equal to zero. But we know summation F actually is a rate of change of momentum. Okay, rate of change of momentum equal to zero. Okay, and meaning dp equal to zero. Okay, dp, that's mean final momentum minus initial momentum equal to zero. And we can rearrange the equation, p initial momentum equal to final momentum, that is we can call is a constant. And we obtain the total initial momentum equal to total of final momentum, or by mathematics writings. Okay, summation initial momentum equal to summation final momentum. During a collision, measurement show that the total momentum does not change. Assuming two objects collide head on. Example, we have object A and object B. By the conservation of momentum, okay, we can write summation of initial momentum
equal to summation of final momentum. Okay,
momentum for initial. Okay, there is for initial. Okay, there is for initial. Okay, there is for initial, and there is for final. Okay, for final. Okay, and the result. Okay, the result we can conclude. Okay, because there is head-on collision. Okay, A move to the left, B move to the right after the collision. For the conservation of momentum, we can also state the total momentum of an isolated system of object remains constant. To understand linear momentum in one dimension collision, okay, we go for we check in example 3.3. Okay, figure 3.4 show an object of mass 200 gram. Okay, collides head on with the object B of mass 100 gram. After the collision, B moves at a speed 2 meters per second with direction to the left. Okay, determine velocity of A after the collision. That means how we write V A. Okay, and by using conservation of momentum, summation initial momentum equal to summation final momentum. Okay, we substitute because we have two objects, object A and object B. There is for object A, there is for object B. Okay, for initial momentum. And there is the formula for object A, and there is formula for object B after the collision. Okay, we substitute with the value, we can get is VA equal to negative 3.5 meter per second. 3.5 meter per second. Okay, and negative sign here indicate that direction of A there is to the left. Another subtopic, 3.2.2 collision. Okay, we can define an isolated event in which two or more body, okay, exerted relatively strong force on each other. Okay, for a relatively short time. Okay, and that collision we can divide a two type. One is elastic, the second one inelastic. Okay, to the conservation in two type of collision. The first one in elastic and the second one in inelastic collision. Okay, look here, there is by the aid of a diagram, the object, an object A and an object B. Okay, colleagues approach, okay, each other, and colleagues, okay, has a collision head on. Okay, head on, and as a result, if elastic, the magnitude of velocity for both object A and object B, okay, according to the diagram, is stronger. Yeah, is stronger, or compare. In elastic collision, the magnitude of velocity after the collision for both an object A and object B is smaller. Okay. Momentum is conserved in all the collision. Momentum is conserved. Okay, but for the kinetic energy, okay, if elastic collision, okay, in elastic collision, okay, we can say the kinetic energy is conserved as well. Okay, is conserved as well. But in elastic, okay, the kinetic energy is not conserved as well. There is a depreciation between two collisions, elastic and inelastic. Okay, here we concentrate in elastic collision, elastic collision in one dimension. Okay, in one dimension. Okay, and okay, we have a graph, okay, or diagram, A and B, A and B. Okay, we have the collision, collision between an object A and object B. Both or an object move in one direction, and that's mean in both in to the rights. Okay, to the rights. Okay, to the rights. And here, okay, we assume the magnitude of velocity an object A is greater than an object B. Okay, and the diagram B, okay, because there is elastic collision, that means both of conservation of momentum and conservation of kinetic energy is constant, we can draw that A, okay, that A, that mass A move to the right also after the collision, but the velocity of an object A is smaller than an object B compare. That's mean the energy produced by object A is transferred to the object B. Okay, and object B. And we can write, okay, to the equation for this allow us to solve the two and noun final speed. Okay, for in elastic collision. Okay, we use a diagram, diagram A and diagram B. Okay, example, assume we have a gun, fire and a fire of bullets, okay, and heat, okay, heat the wooden, the hanging wooden block, okay, hanging wooden block, this one, okay, and after the collision, okay, that bullet is embedded inside the wooden block, and that wooden block will be move, okay, with move to the right and going up about h from the initial level. Okay, in elastic collision, some of initial kinetic energy is lost to the thermal or potential energy, and here, okay, and here, okay, that we assume is produced a thermal energy, okay, heat energy, okay, thermal energy or heat energy, okay, and also plus the potential energy. Okay, or during the explosion, okay, maybe the energy addition and addition of chemical or nuclear energy can be produced. Okay, can be produced. Okay, a complete inelastic collision is one where the object stick together after a work. It's different for elastic collision. Okay, elastic collision, both of object is not stick together. And here, there is only one final velocity. Okay, produced by the collision. And we go for the full definition for elastic collision. Okay, elastic collision we can define as which the total kinetic energy as well as total momentum of system is the same before and after. Okay, which the total kinetic energy as well as total momentum of the system is the same before and after the collision. Okay, by the aid of the diagram, here is a two billiards ball. Okay, ball one and ball two. Okay, his hit on. Okay, after the collision. Okay, they move will be move in opposite direction, and it's not stick together. Okay, ball one move to the left, ball two move to the right. Property for the elastic collision, actually have two. One, total momentum is conserved. Or we also can write here summation for initial momentum equal to summation of final momentum. The second one of property, total kinetic energy is conserved. Summation in a initial kinetic energy, okay, equal to summation of final kinetic energy. Okay, because there is collision of two and object. Okay, we can write like this equation. Okay, there is a before, and there is a after. Okay. In elastic or non-elastic collision, okay, is defined. Okay, the total kinetic energy of the system is not the same before and after the collision, even through the total momentum of the system is conserved. Assume we have an inelastic collision of two billiard balls. Ball one is moved to the right, with the initial velocity u1, but ball two at the rest, and we write u2, initial velocity for ball two is zero, and we have the collision. Okay, after the collision, both a ball move to the right. Okay, both of ball move to the right. Okay, and caution. Okay, not all the inelastic collision is put together. Okay, in fact, inelastic collision include many situations which the body do not stick. Okay, it do not stick. It's not all the condition. Okay, it's not all the condition. Okay, look here. What the property for inelastic collision? Okay, the first one, the total momentum is conserved. It's conserved. Okay, it's conserved. And the second property for in collision, kinetic energy is not conserved. Okay, it's not conserved. That means summation initial energy is not conserved. Okay, final kinetic energy. Okay,
But the third property, total energy is conserved. Okay, we write summation E is time for initial energy equal to summation for final energy. Or we can write kinetic energy, initial kinetic energy equal to summation of final kinetic energy plus losses energy. For the summary, okay, for the summary, Newton's second law, okay, summation, impulsive force, okay, summation force, there is a equal to changing in momentum divide changing in time, okay, or there is a rate of, we can say is there is a rate of change of momentum. Okay, the second, total momentum of an isolated system of object is conserved. Okay, during the collision, the colliding object can be considered to be an isolated system, even if the external force exists, as long as they are not too large. Okay? They are not too large. Momentum will be, therefore, be conserved during the collision. Conserved during the collision. Summary for topic 3. In momentum and impulse. Okay, we have two quantity. One is momentum. Definition for momentum is product of mass and velocity of an object. The equation is P equal to mv. The second quantity, impulse. The definition is product of force F and the time t for which it acts. The equation J equal to average F dt. The second definition for impulse, chain of momentum. The equation J equal to M delta V. Collision. We have two types of collision. One is elastic and another one is an inelastic collision. Okay, we have two properties to discuss here, to state here. Okay, the first one is elastic collision, total momentum is conserved. And also for inelastic collision, total momentum is conserved. The second property for elastic collision, total kinetic energy is conserved. Sum of initial kinetic energy equal to sum of final kinetic energy. Okay, but in elastic collision, total kinetic energy is not conserved. That means sum of initial kinetic energy equal to sum of final kinetic energy plus losses energy.